Debian 10 Buster with GNOME Desktop. What I like, dislike, and would I recommend it as a desktop operating system? You will find out in this Debian 10 review. Before you hear my opinion, please comment below on what you think about Debian 10 with GNOME Desktop, and we will see if there is any overlap in our experience. Let's start with the positive things. The speed of Debian 10 is incredible. It seems to be even faster than my Arch Linux with Plasma 5. The boot time is around 5-10 seconds. All applications open almost instantly. The effects are smooth. I have not experienced a single lag or a crash. Well, there was one application that crashed, but it is not the Debian fault, and I will talk about that later. Multiple factors contributed to this performance improvement. I just would like to mention that AppArmor is the default mandatory access control system in Debian 10. I recall when I tried Fedora some years ago, AppArmor slowed down the system a lot. It was one of the major reasons I uninstalled Fedora. I have not seen such problem in Debian 10. Everything works lightning fast. Another factor that makes Debian 10 fast is vanilla GNOME shell. Debian 10 uses the default clean GNOME desktop. There are no extra extensions, themes, or apps that may affect the performance. Maybe some users would like to see more customized desktop, but this is not how Debian does things. I think it is better to get this clean GNOME desktop and customize it than removing installed applications and extensions. GNOME shell is a little outdated already, but it is not a problem. Let me explain. The Debian team focuses on stability. They need time to test the software. So when a program makes it to the stable branch of Debian, it is already old. I think this was a problem for Debian 9. GNOME shell was still undeveloped at that time, and even if all bugs were fixed, it did not deliver a pleasant user experience. Debian 10 is shipped with GNOME 3.30. I think this GNOME shell is much better thought out. Although I am not a fan of GNOME, and I prefer Plasma 5 desktop, I could use Debian 10 GNOME without strong discomfort. I even like it, except for a few things I will mention in the dislike part of this video. So, I think GNOME users will be happy with Debian 10. In this review, I will talk only about Debian 10 with GNOME Desktop. I will cover other desktop environments in separate videos. So make sure you have subscribed and activated the bell notification. Resource usage. Debian 10 GNOME is not the lightest on RAM. It takes around 1 GB of RAM right after the login, but this is because of the GNOME desktop. However, the CPU usage stays quite low most of the time. The system takes about 12 gigs, which is relatively small. If you run Debian on a server without the graphical interface, it is super light. For example, I installed Debian 10 on my AppCloud server. It takes only 1 GB of disk space and 32 MB of RAM. You can also test Debian 10 on a server for free. Just use the promo code LU25 during the registration at appcloud.com and you will get $25 to your account. Then you can deploy a private Debian server with just a few clicks and start using it. AppCloud provides the fastest servers with great reliability and very responsive support. Surprisingly, Debian 10 GNOME also works really well in VirtualBox. I almost did not feel I was in a virtual machine. While with Ubuntu, for example, I can barely do things in a virtual machine, and I have done all the experiments with settings and VirtualBox guest editions. So I think Debian's resource usage is very reasonable. I am not going to list all new features of Debian 10. You can find them in the release notes. I would only like to mention that Debian 10 has improved the support of UEFI. The UEFI support was first introduced in Debian 7, but it never worked fine in my experience. I was not able to install even Debian 9 on my computer in the UEFI mode. Debian 10 boots fine with the UEFI mode. Debian 10 also includes CAPS driverless printers, so your printer should be recognized out of the box. I don't have a printer to confirm that, but from what I have read online, it does work. Debian 10 also introduces a new installer. The Calamars installer is available in live images only. I'm still not sure if it will become the default installer, but it is a great step forward from the old and confusing Debian installer. I give an overview of Debian's Calamars installer in my previous video. Check it out. I was also pleased to see that Debian upgraded OpenGDK from version 8 to version 11. There are many other changes, such as bin and sbin are symlinked to usr, IP tables are replaced with NF tables, NF tables are supposed to provide better performance. But these are more specific changes and many end users may not even notice them. There is also one thing that has not changed. Many distros tend to drop their 32-bit support, but Debian still supports the 32-bit systems. If you have very old 32-bit hardware, Debian may help you to bring it to life. Applications. I have mentioned already that Debian 10 GNOME is pretty clean distro. It includes only the essential applications, and I like that. I would only remove all the games, but maybe other users need them. It's just me, who don't play computer games and instead kills his time by creating these YouTube videos. One of the first things I liked was that Debian 10 GNOME includes GNOME tweaks by default. The tweaks utility can be used to change window buttons, themes, fonts, and other visual components. This helped me a lot to make GNOME comfortable for my use. I also like that GNOME provides a complete set of applications such as mail client, calendar, tasks, maps, and others. It has been a while since I checked these apps. Evolution and other apps have evolved into usable state. I enjoyed using them. Long-term support. Debian 10 will be supported for the next 5 years. This is another serious reason to consider installing it. You will have one of the most stable distro for 5 years without the need to reinstall it. After some praise, let's criticize it. The installer. Debian's installer is one of the weakest points of Debian. It just makes installing Debian difficult. There are many Debian images and new users simply don't understand which ISO image to download. The partition manager is complicated. Its multiple windows confuse even experienced Linux users. Often users cannot get their Wi-Fi work because Debian doesn't include proprietary firmware in its standard installation ISO. One has to download the non-free ISO. Sudo will not be enabled if you create a root password. If you install Debian from a DVD, after the installation, you will get the error "repository CD-ROM does not have a release file." I explained all these points in my Debian 10 installation guide. Watch it if you want to install Debian 10 without hassle. Wayland. Debian 10 uses Wayland by default. I was a little surprised with this big step forward. Wayland is still not good enough to be the main display manager. Synaptic doesn't work with Wayland, and it is difficult for me to imagine using Debian without the Synaptic package manager. Simple Screen Recorder fails to record the desktop with Wayland. Color Picker also doesn't work with Wayland. I cannot imagine my video production without the last two applications, so Wayland is a deal breaker for me. Luckily, one can choose between Wayland, Xorg, and even GNOME Classic. I switched to the Xorg session where everything works perfectly and never used Wayland after that. The desktop. The desktop issues are more of GNOME fault than Debian, but it is part of the distribution experience, so I need to discuss it too. Windows have no minimize button. This reminded me of elementary OS. It seems to be a trend nowadays. Unfortunately, I don't get it, and I need the minimize button. However, unlike elementary, Debian has tweaks installed by default, so adding the minimize button was easy. I also moved them to the left side. I don't remember how many times I complained about this, but I will keep saying it. The file manager should have an option to have different view in different folders. It seems to be logical to have an icon view style for pictures and detailed or list view for documents, as an example. In GNOME, if you change the view settings, it changes globally for all folders. I just can't stand this behavior. The network icon shows this question mark sometimes. I first thought I lost the connection, but I didn't. Everything was fine and my internet worked, so this was a little confusing. I do not like Rhythmbox. I think there are better Linux music players. But since it was pre-installed, I gave it a try. I did not like that Watch Library for new files is not enabled by default. It took me some time to go through all the settings and figure out why it did not see the music files in my music folder. I also wanted to add some startup scripts, including the one that's supposed to fix synaptic issues in Wayland, but the startup menu accepts only listed applications. To add the script, you need to place it in .config autostart folder. Codecs. Debian doesn't play some media files. It complains about the absence of some codecs and offers you to install them. And then you see that all suggested codecs are installed, but some of your media files still don't play. I know how to fix this, and I will cover it in my next video on things to do after installing Debian 10. I just wish Debian had an easier way to get the necessary codecs. KDE applications. If you need to install some KDE applications in GNOME, be ready to face some issues. KDE apps do not work well in Debian GNOME. They also look much worse in GNOME than GTK apps in Plasma 5. I needed KDE in life for my video editing. I edited my Debian 10 installation video in Debian 10 GNOME, and it was a nightmare. KDE in life crashed all the time. Some fragments simply disappeared from the timeline. I was very angry. KDE in life also made my computer cooler very noisy. It struggled to work in Debian 10 GNOME. I used KDE in life 18.12 for my editing with Plasma 5 on Arch Linux. I have edited many videos with it. It did crash from time to time, but crashes were relatively rare if I compare it to my Debian 10 GNOME experience. It also worked quietly in Plasma 5. There are also some small issues. They did not affect me, but I would like to mention them. Sound recorder, that is included by default, crashes. But I use Audacity for sound recording anyway. LibreOffice becomes unexpectedly small when you exit the maximized mode. Resizing it manually fixes the problem. I also would like to see some backup programs pre-installed in Debian 10. Speaking about backups, I have seen online that many users would like to use Debian with ButterFS file system to make system snapshots, like you can do, for example, with TimeShift in Ubuntu. Although Debian 10 supports ButterFS, there is no subvolume support, so you cannot make system snapshots by default. You may also find multiple versions of the same package listed in the Software Center. Debian also doesn't have Flatpak or Snap support by default, but if you want to use these portable package formats, you can install either of them from the repositories. All in all, I like this GNOME release of Debian. If you asked me would I install Ubuntu or Debian GNOME, I would choose Debian. It is much better in terms of performance. Thank you for watching!